Hello, this is Bern, and if you've taken the courageous step of leaving a guy that is not good for you, but you're scared you're not going to be strong enough to pull it off, or you're already having second doubts, and even though intellectually you know it's the worst thing that can happen to you, emotionally you still crave his presence, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you 6 steps to ensure that you can leave him for good. Stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great LiveTV.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And on today's episode, I'm gonna be sharing with you a 6-step process to stay away from a guy who's bad for you. Now, if you like what I have to share on this video, stick with me until the end, because I'm gonna be sharing with you an opportunity for free to get into a much deeper training that will help you beyond what I can share with you today. Let's get started. Listen, I created a video about a couple of years ago that's already been watched over 600,000 times that was titled 3 Signs You Should Leave a Man. And I know that that's like part of the story, like how to recognize. I'm gonna link up the description of this under the description of the video if you wanna watch it later. But if you've recognized already that the guy that you were with is not good and you've already left him, but you're scared about going back, you're not sure how to stay congruent with the commitment to yourself, here are the 6 steps I ask you and urge you to follow to ensure you don't mess up your love life by going to a guy that's bad for you, an addictive relationship, a guy who's abusive in nature, and who will never be able to give you what you want. Step number 1 is to viscerally connect to the future that you will have should you go back on that decision that you made. So what do I mean by that? I mean, take some time to fully, and I mean fully, envision, visualize your life in the future. A year from now, 3 years from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, how your life will be in every aspect, physically, emotionally, mentally, in terms of your dreams, in terms of the people who love you, in terms of the way you look. If you continue with a guy who's abusive, a guy who can't give you what you want, a guy who's cheating on you, a guy who doesn't have what it takes to be with you, if you've already determined he's not the guy for you and you go back, I want you to, instead of having selective memory and just connect to the part of you that's super excited to feel that energy from him, that in addition to that, which you might do if you want to, can really focus on what your life will be if you don't change this, where your heart will end up in the end if you go back to someone who is absolutely the wrong fit for you. So that's step number 1. Viscerally connect, not intellectually, viscerally connect to the pain of the future you'll have if you go back. Number 2, make a public commitment to those you love most. Why? Because if you keep this to yourself, that's gonna be, you'll have certain strength. But if you connect with people who are people you love, people who admire you, people that you admire, and you make your commitment not just to yourself, but to them, you're gonna be a lot, you're gonna think about it 3 times more before you go back into it. Why? Because then you also have to face not just like, well, I failed on me, but I failed to them. So make a decision to be more vocal and be more expressive in terms of your commitment to people who are part of your support system so that they also hold you accountable to your truth. Step number 3, if you haven't done this, you may have done this already, but if you haven't, block this dude completely. What do I mean by that? Facebook, email, make sure that all the emails he sends you go to the trash. I mean, of course, if this is a guy that's an ex-husband of yours and you have children together, this step is not possible, right? But if this is a guy that you really don't have to see again in the future for any reason other than your own addictive nature, then I urge you to take the courageous step of blocking him in every platform you have: Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, email, phone, every way that you can. Block him out so that you don't have the constant reminder. Delete his phone from your system also if you need to after you block him. Why? Because you want to make sure that you don't receive messages from him and you don't feel tempted to call him. Number 4, anticipate challenges. Why? Because if you say, well, I'm doing all of this and I'm never going to feel like I crave this dude, understand that you're not just craving him. You're craving him not just because you love him. You're craving him because you feel some level of addiction towards the relationship. You feel a level of attachment that is not love. The problem becomes when you crave a guy and you say, well, I crave him obviously because I love him so much. That's only part of it. Sometimes you crave him because you crave intensity in sick ways. Sometimes you crave him because you are addicted to the relationship or to him. And that's not healthy, and that is definitely not love. So anticipate challenges. Know that there's going to be times where you're going to say, well, I just have to give him this $3 thing that he left in my house, therefore I have to see him again. Anticipate little things like that where you'll start bullshitting yourself in terms of why you really have to see him. There's no reason whatsoever for you to see him again. So stop telling yourself that there is. If there really are no reasons to see him, don't give yourself little excuses. Well, it's just one time. It's his birthday, or his mother died 10 years ago this day, so he has to hear from me. Don't do this to yourself. Don't BS yourself. And do the courageous thing. Anticipate the challenges and know what you will do. Whenever you want to call him, who are you going to call instead? Who's going to be your support system? So whenever you feel like, I need to text this dude, you're going to text your best friend, you're going to text your mentor, whoever you're working with. You're going to do something that's opposite of the connection with him, okay? Number five, create a larger identity. Why do I say this? Because if you just solve this challenge to get away from a painful relationship, you'll be able to have a certain degree of power in doing so. If you create a bigger identity, if you create a new vision for what your life is, a vision for yourself that's so juicy, so exciting, so it wakes you up in the morning with excitement to see, this is the kind of woman I want to become, this is the kind of woman I'm becoming, and there's no place for fuckery of this kind, of this type of person in my life. For that type of woman, this is a no-brainer. This guy is not a part of that identity. Create a bigger identity so that the bigger identity not pulls you towards something bigger than just solving this little problem, stepping into the kind of life, the kind of role model, the kind of message, the kind of mission in the world where this individual and this type of relationship have no place whatsoever. Last step, and I gave this for last because I want to make sure that you listen to the whole thing, but make no mistake, there's some women right now who are listening to this that this will be more than enough and they'll be able to pull it off. There's some of you, my dears, that this video or 250 other videos will not be enough. And for you, I'm talking about right now, you need to get help. That help might come in the form of a support group. That help might come in the form of a mentorship or a coach, for example, what I do, right? But it's not a fit for everyone. So you could be a therapist, it could be a coach, it could be a mentor, it could be a group, it could be a group of friends. The more professional, the better. Why? Because you'll be able to get out of pain sooner. Do not underestimate the power of getting real, sustainable accountability and help to help you, not if things get challenging, when things get challenging. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three quick things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out future videos. Number three, and most important of all, if part of the reason why you're not letting go of this guy is because you feel that you can't create a strong connection with someone as intense as you had it, I'm going to tell you right now that you absolutely can. And to prove it to you, I've created a framework and a training that will share with you in no uncertain terms how you can create a strong, powerful connection with someone that's the right fit, done the right way, and a healthy way for you. And all you have to do, it's absolutely free, all you have to do is click on the first line on the description of this video. Click on that, you'll be taken to a page where you have to do is click on the yellow bar, enter your name and email, and you'll be taken directly to that training to start benefiting from that and understand that it's possible to leave a guy behind because there's many more opportunities for you in the future. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.